CIET-NCERT presents curriculum-based series Dhwani Shala. Let's join in Dhwani Shala, class 6.
Hello, my dear friends. How are you? I hope you all are safe, happy and loved. My name is Mansi. You can also call me as Mansi Didi. Today, we will begin our first chapter of 6th standard, that is, knowing our numbers. In this lesson, we will try to compare different numbers. We will also try to represent large numbers using place value. And we will also learn how to estimate large numbers. But before we begin, make sure you have a notebook, a pen, a sharpened pencil, and an eraser. So now friends, in our previous classes, we have learnt how to count. We all can count very easily. We can count the number of things around us. We always count the number of chapatis we eat. We count the numbers of cars following us. We always try to count the stars in the sky or rice in our plate. But we can never count them completely. We all begin our counting from 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. But friends, can you write the biggest number you know? Let us see, what is it? Is it 100, 1000, 10,000 or crore? Some of you must have been feeling very proud if you know crore or more than that. Whatever the number is, just add 1 to it. It became a bigger number than the previous number you knew. You can add 1 again and it will go on and on. You know friends, no one has ever counted the last number till date. Whatever you will count, you can add 1 to it and it will go on. So friends, can you see that numbers never end? They are infinite. They go on and on, just like the number of ants in this world or the stars in our sky. Have you ever counted the number of leaves in your neighborhood tree? Yes, we can never count them. They are like our numbers. They go on and on without ending. Now, my dear friends, can you tell me how many digits are there? They are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 0. So in total, we have 10 digits. Do you know all the numbers that we can think of are made with these digits only? The numbers of students in our class, our scooter number or bus number, the number of pages in your maths textbook, or the number of houses in our street, the numbers given on your phone screen also. All these numbers are just these 10 digits. Now friends, let us write a number 23 in our notebook. We have learnt that 23 can be expanded as 20 plus 3, or we can also say it as 2 tens and 3 ones. Let us try expanding 95. We can expand it as 90 plus 5, or we can also say it as 9 tens and 5 ones. It will be 95. Now friends, below 95, we have to write 7, 2, 3. Now, how we can expand this number? Let us check. 3 is at 1's place, 2 is at 10's place and 7 is at 100's place. So, we can write it as 700 plus 20 plus 3. So, 723. Can you also expand 9723? Let us go from right. 3 is at 1's place, 2 is at 10's place, 7 is at 100's place and 9 is at 1000's place. So, we can write it as 9 thousands. How many zeros? 3 zeros. 9, 0, 0, 0 plus 700. 7, 0, 0 plus 20 plus 3. We can speak it as 9,723. Now friends, let us try to expand 1, 9, 7, 2, 3. How many digits are there? There are 5 digits. Now let us go from right. 3 is at 1's place, 2 is at 10's place, 7 is at 100's place, 9 is at 1000's place, and 1 is at 10,000's place. Now this number will be expanded as 19,000 plus 700 plus 20 plus 3. It will be 19,723. Let us try to expand 2, 7, 8, 9, 0, 5. I repeat, let us try to expand 2, 7, 8, 9, 0, 5. How many digits are there? There are 6 digits. So, to read this number, let us start from right. Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000s, and lakhs. So 2 is at lakhs place. So we have 2,78,905. It will be expanded as 2. How many zeros? How many digits are after 2? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we have 5 digits. We will write 5 zeros. So 2, 0, 0, 0, 0 and 0. Plus 78 and 3 zeros. That will be 78,000. And plus 9 into 100. That is 900. Why? Because 9 is at 100's place. Since there is nothing at 10's place, we will leave it plus 5, which is at 1's place. So we have 2,78,905. Let us try 5,09,000. How can we expand this number? Do you find it difficult or easy? It's very easy. To read this number, let us start from right. Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000s, and lakhs. So 5 is at lakhs place. So we have 5,09,000. Since there are no numbers other than 0, we can write it as 5,09,000. So now we have learnt how to expand large numbers. We have used place values here. Now friends, let us play a game. Now I will give you digits and you will try to make a bigger number and a smaller number using only the given digits without repeating. I repeat the rules of the game so that all can play together. In this game, I will give you digits and you will try to make a bigger number and a smaller number using the given digits. But the rule is that no one will repeat the digits. So, let us take 3 and 1. The first number we can make is 13. And the other number can be made by reversing the digits, we will get 31. From these numbers, what do you think the bigger number will be? The bigger number is 31 and the smaller number is 13. How you all guessed that? Yes. Since 3 is at 10's place, while in 13, 1 is at 10's place, and we know that 3 is more than 1, so 31 is a bigger number than 13. Let's play at a harder level now. Let us try making a bigger number and a smaller number using 1, 3, 7. The biggest number can be made by using 7 at 100's place, 3 at 10's place, and then 1 at 1's place. It will be read as 700 and 31. Here we have written the biggest digit first, then the smaller to it, and then the smallest digit. 7 was the biggest digit, then came 3, and then 1, which was the smallest digit from 1, 3, and 7. Now, to make the smallest number, we will write 1 at hundredths place, 3 at tens place, and 7 at ones place. We will get 137. Friends, we can see that 1 is the smallest digit in 137. So it has come at hundredths place. While 7 is the largest digit in 137, it has come at ones place. Now let us move to another question. Let us now write the biggest number and the smallest number using the digits 4, 0, 2, 5. Here, the biggest digit is 5. So we will write it at thousands place. The smaller digit is 4, which will come at hundredths place. Then 2 at tens place. And since 0 is the smallest digit, it will come at ones place. So the number formed is 5420, which will be read as 5420. To make the smallest number using these digits, the smallest digit is 0. But friends, can we start a number using 0 and form a 4-digit number? No. If we will start the number using 0, it will become a 3-digit number. Since we have to write a 4-digit number, so we will select a number greater than 0. In this case, it is 2. How? We had the number 4025. 0 is the smallest number. But since we can't take 0, we will take 2. So, 2 will come at thousands place and 0 will come at hundredths place. Then 4 at tens place and 5 at ones place. So, the number we will get is 2045. So, let us see from the digits 4025, the biggest number formed was 5420, while the smallest number formed was 2045. Let us take another 4 digits now. Please write 1, 6, 2, 3. Here, the biggest digit is 6. So we will write it at thousands place. The smaller digit is 3, which will come at hundredths place. Then 2 at tens place and 1 will be at ones place. Why? Because 1 is the smallest digit here. The number formed is 6321 or 6321. Now, to make the smallest number using these digits, the smallest digit here is 1. It will come at thousands place. 2 will come at hundredths place, then 3 at tens place and 6 at ones place. So the number we will get is 1236 or 1236. Let us see how we did that. We had the 4 digits 1623 and the biggest number we formed was 6321, while the smallest number formed was 1236. Let us take 5 digits now. Please write 10023. I repeat, let us write 10023. Here the biggest digit is 3. And how many digits are there? 5 digits are there. So 5 will come at 10 thousandths place. The smaller digit is 2, which will come at thousandths place. Then 1 will come at hundredths place. The remaining zeros will come at tens and ones. Why 2 zeros? Because we had 10023. So the biggest number formed is 32100, which can be also read as 32,000 100. To make the smallest number using these digits, the smallest number here is 0. But if we start the number using 0, then will this number be a 5-digit number? No, it will become a 3-digit number because there are 2 zeros. So, since we need a 5-digit number, so we will select a number greater than 0. In this case, we have 1. So, it will come at tens thousands place, while 0 will come at thousands place and hundreds place. Then 2 will come at tens place and 3, which is the largest digit here, will come at ones place. So the number we will get is 10023 or 10023. Easy, right? Now see how big numbers we are making on our own. Let us try to form the biggest and smallest 6 digits number using 7, 6, 5, 3, 4, 8. The biggest number will be 876543, which will be read as 876543. And friends, the smallest number will be 345678, which will be read as 3,45,678. Now friends, right now I was giving you number and we were forming biggest number and smallest number together. But what if I don't give you a number, I just ask you to write a largest one digit number. Do you know what is the largest one digit number? Yes, it is 9. And what is the largest two digits number? It is 99. So what will be the largest 4-digit number? You are guessing correctly. It is 9999. That is 9999. Friends, can you see the smallest 3-digit number is 100 and the smallest 2-digit number is 10. So to write the smallest 4-digit number, should we start with the smallest digit, that is 0. But if we will do that, we will make it a 3-digit number. So, to write the smallest 4-digit number, we will write 1000, which is 1000. What will be the smallest 5-digit number? It will be 10,000. Now friends, let us practice some more. I will give you two numbers. You have to tell which is a bigger number and which one is a smaller number. So, first is 5 and 15. What do you think? Which number is a bigger number? You can easily see that 5 has only one digit while 15 has two digits, one at ones place and one at tens place. So, it's very easy that 15 is a bigger number than 5. So, let us move to the next question. You have 18 and 81. I repeat, you have 18 and 81. Both the numbers have two digits, 1 and 8. Now, how you will tell which number is a bigger number? You can see that at tens place, in 18 there is 1, while in 81, at tens place there is 8. We know that 1 is less than 8, or 8 is a bigger number than 1. So, we can say that 81 is a bigger number than 18. Let us move to another question. Now we have 83 and 89. Now again, both the numbers have two digits. 8, 3 and 8, 9. Now, how to tell which number is a bigger number? You can see that in both the numbers, at tens place, we have a same digit, 8. So, how we can tell that 83 is bigger or 89 is bigger? Now, we will see the digits at ones place. In 83, we have 3 at ones place, while in 89, we have 9 at ones place. Do you know which one is bigger, 3 or 9? Yes, you are correct. It is 9. 9 is a bigger number than 3. So, from 83 and 89, we know that 89 is a bigger number than 83. Let us move to another question. 995 and 998. I repeat, we have 995 and 998. Now, both the numbers are 3 digits number and both the numbers have same hundreds place and tens place, that is 9 and 9. So, how will you tell which number is a bigger number? Again, we will see the digits at ones place. In 995 or 995, we have 5 at ones place. In 998 or 998, we have 8 at ones place. So, we know that 8 is a bigger number than 5. Therefore, 998 is a bigger number than 995. I repeat, 998 is a bigger number than 995. Friends, let us do another question. Please write 2309 and 2037. What we have written? 2309, which can be read as 2309, and 2037, which can be read as 2037. Now, both the numbers have same number of digits. They both have 4 digits. And now, you can also see that at thousands place, they are same digits, that is 2. So, how you will tell which number is a bigger number? Let us check at hundreds place. At hundreds place, in 2309, we have 3. In hundreds place, in 2037, we have 0. So, we can compare 3 and 0 and we know that 3 is a bigger number than 0. So, we can say that 2309, that is 2309, is a bigger number than 2037. So, friends, what all we did today? We tried to compare different numbers. We also tried to make large numbers. We tried to represent large numbers using place value. So, friends, will you all practice these questions at home? So, I'm giving you 2-3 questions. Please practice so that in our next lesson, we know how to compare numbers and how to represent numbers using place values. So, the first part is 998 and 976. I repeat, 998 and 976. Second part is 314 and 370. I repeat, 314 and 370. Our last part is 888 and 880. You will compare these numbers and write which number is a smaller number. So friends, let us end our today's lesson and we will meet again. Till then, stay happy and stay safe.
Friends, you are just listening to the series Dhwani Shala. Production Assistant, Amit Kumar. This series Dhwani Shala was recorded by Bati Langlingdo, produced by Ajit Horo. And this program is brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.